like to say that this video is going to be about theory, but actually it will be a video mostly about speculations, about my thoughts in things that are extremely not clear, nor from a technical standpoint, because OpenAI never disclosed how O1 and O3 work, and nor it is clear from that theoretical point of view in the study of LLMs what's going on inside. So there are two unknowns and we can just speculate, but still I gave to these topics a lot of thoughts in recent weeks, and I want to share it with you as an exercise also to try to clarify my own opinions on this kind of things. This video was actually stimulated by the fact that there are certain researchers that were very LLM skeptics, and now they are saying, with O1 or with O3, everything is different now. Yes, LLMs are the way to go. They are able to generalize reasoning. They are no longer stochastic parrots like they claimed just a few months ago. And I believe that while chain of thoughts models, explicitly models that have this feature built in a very explicit way, like O1, is a very interesting concept, it doesn't change the inner working of the model. It remains an autoregressive model where there is no actual symbolic reasoning, but still everything is encoded in implicitly in some way in the latent in the space of the model. So I believe that these researchers are just exploiting the this change, this small change in paradigm in order to validate in order to don't admit that they were wrong. And I will zoom about this issue and why I think it's like that during the video. To start, let's go backward in time 2-3 years. Do you remember the two important papers in 2022? I think the first one was LLMs are few-shot learners. Basically, if the researcher asked some question to the LLM, it failed. But if it asked the same question with a few examples, so not zero shot, but few shots, like what is the reply to this question? And then with a few examples or of similar problems, then the LLM could generalize it and could reply correctly. But then there was an even more interesting paper that was stimulated by this one, that was like a thing in step. Basically, just adding thing in step to the model prompt would result in a better outcome, more correct replies and enhanced capabilities. To start, I want to claim that this observations are more discoveries than innovations. Basically, in some way, LLMs have this feature built in, to the point that you can ask thing in step, and it will basically enrich the context window of the prompt, and then reply in a more exact way. What's happening when this happens? For once, this is surely a form of search inside the latent space. Basically, the model zero shot cannot retrieve the best absolute reply to a given question. But when it starts a search for potential solutions, out of many solutions, the reasoning capabilities of the model are strong enough to pick the best among them. And in my view, this shows that the models have the semantical capability to reply to these questions. It's just that, a human that can reply zero shot in a correct way to easy questions, but a researcher that is doing frontier research will take years of chain of thoughts, researching, going forward, realizing a solution is bad, going backward. But this is this happens basically even to humans when the things they are trying to reply are at the limit of their abilities. But still, what is interesting in my opinion about all this is that clearly there is a gap between what a model can do zero shot and the ability instead of a model to choose among different solutions still in the latent space. So we are talking about the model augmenting the prompt itself by providing potential solutions. But still, this inference happens in the next token. It's still an autoregressive model outputting the next token. So I believe that this is some kind of symbolic reasoning, is bogus, and it's just a way to defend yourself from past errors. I suspect that the way why certain people are so better than other people to use LLMs is exactly because of that. There are humans that when they use LLMs are very good at making the LLM output all the potential solutions for that given problem, and also there are humans that are good at avoiding that the LLM get trapped into a weak solution. And then with all this enriched context, if the good user of an LLM is able to let the LLM reply in the best possible way. The contrary to that is to just write a one-liner and expect the model to reply one shot. But as I said, I believe that this capability, even if 1 or 3 and DeepSeek version 3 with the thing button pressed and whatever is a feature of this specific model which amplify this ability, this thing seems to be part of the most LLMs anyway, because even if we kinda disabled this ability in the second stage of training, when there is basically the refinement looking at questions and answers, these questions and answers are most of the times in a zero-shot form. It's a question and then the perfect reply. So the models tried to simulate that in the first iterations of LLMs when this chain of thoughts was not trained to the model. But in the first step of the learning, when you do basically the massive amount of learning needed to obtain your base model, the model will see a lot of forums, discussion groups, and things like that, where there is a step-by-step process with also false paths and then backtracking and then so forth. So even if later this is kinda destroyed, the model look at the human knowledge, and the human knowledge is made also of this kind of things. So basically we are just making it more explicit, and that's it. So basically it's a form of search inside the latent space. I think the LLMs have this concept kind of built in already in the base model, and also there is to notice that I don't believe this is going to be the silver bullet to make LLMs much stronger. For example, Claude Sonnet can reply zero shot often better than GPT-4.01 because it's a more capable model. So probably Claude Sonnet with a long chain of thoughts can reply better than vanilla Claude Sonnet. But in general, I believe you have to have a very strong model as a basis, and then the model can be augmented with this technique. It's like a human being. You cannot take a human which is very not competent or not intelligent enough in a given discipline and then allow they to just blab forever and they will converge to some interesting solution. So Yes, humans also do that. It's a fundamental part of the reasoning step, but I don't believe that this alone is going to solve reasoning for LLMs. Also, the model must be very strong at identifying which of the context created is the better solution, and this is cannot be fixed just outputting searching in the latent space, but it needs the ability to reason and to weight different solutions and their small pitfalls in order to pick the best one. Thanks for following and bye.